Meanwhile, more bodies are being discovered at that crematory in Georgia. So far, more than 200 sets of remains have now been uncovered. The search site has expanded to new areas as well, including the backyard of Tri-State Crematory operator Ray Brent Marsh. More than 30 funeral homes sent bodies there, and people from as far away as Canada are looking for information. Meanwhile, Marsh remains in jail, charged for now with theft by deception. Now, the question is, could what happened in Georgia happen in Hawaii? Our state has over 10 crematoriums, none of which have any type of state laws to follow or regulations to meet. KTMV9's Marisa Reza joins us now and tells us whether those protocols could protect us.
Well, Kim and Jim, ironically, Georgia does have crematory laws, but regulators apparently weren't doing their job. Now, so while government regulation would provide a watchdog element, it might not necessarily protect consumers from what happened in Georgia. Now, funeral directors say once a body is cremated, the remains are impossible to identify. Crematoriums attach a stainless steel ID tag to each body, so it can be positively ID'd when the process is finished. Since there are no specific cremation laws covering the treatment of the body or the cremated remains, the tag becomes part of the chain of identification.
We have a very solid paper trail that we follow. We have a identification procedure that happens immediately when the body arrives here. And the body is identified with a steel tag that has a number on it that follows the body at all times.
Now, the only real government regulations crematoriums must follow relate to air quality and emissions from their smokestacks. So the answer to the could it happen here question, the operators say no. But there is no government regulation to make certain. The Hawaii Funeral Directors Association has started working on a model cremation law for Hawaii. It hopes that if a law is created, that it would provide another layer of comfort to people in their time of grief.